try one first anyway.
Concert at the end.
And they did a video with me and the old mayor's office.
Oh, sure.
That's the back, absolutely.
It actually came on a Sunday afternoon, I think it was a 2 o'clock start, if I remember right.
Yeah, that's right.
And so that was when I first became aware of Ken, and probably of Liverpool. Well, between Ken and the Beatles, then I knew about Liverpool.
You know, quite a bit.
I always look out for red lights.
Yes, that's right.
Lord Mayor, would it be possible just to say a few words to Lady Anne, really, I think, about just officially handing out, it would be quite useful for the radio.
Well, I think the book, it's a great memorial of Ken, but the messages inside are the most important things, yeah. Because you get a sense of how Liverpool thought of Ken, and will continue, yes, to think of Ken, because in Liverpool's minds, Ken's still with us. And I'm proud to be handing this over to you. It's been a mark. I said in one article I wrote that it's as if my year had been defined by Ken.
Thank you.
And it was such a pleasure to know him, and such a privilege as well. And I'm proud to be able to hand this to you as a memorial from the people of Liverpool to you.
This is absolutely wonderful. I mean, it's so beautifully bound, and I've had a little look through at some of the messages. They're quite incredible. If I read them out now, they certainly bring tears to your eyes. There's so much love, and the memories people have. Everybody seems to have met him, but he spoke to everybody in the street. I don't know if anybody has met him, but he'd never get away. He would just chat to everybody. He always had a special remark for everybody. What do you do? Where you come from? Whatever. That was him. And this is what people are remembering. And this is the biggest. And Tavron from the Flora Pavilion that had a book there. The Grand Theatre in Blackpool with a book. It's quite incredible. So, I mean, this is the biggest and best. But it's quite amazing how many people have wanted to put their own thoughts down on paper. Very moving, I can tell you. It's just lovely. You've taken so much trouble to have it bound. It's they were all separate pieces of paper, I believe.
They were originally. As I said to you, that I was given a good piece of advice by the town hall, was to make sure that I didn't leave any space at the top and at the bottom for my message. So it gave me plenty of space in which to say what I thought of Ken and what he meant to me.
And if he'd have been here, he would have been at your special gala on Saturday.
Oh, yes, we've got the gala concert on Saturday. Ken, by the time that the year was over, and I'm so pleased to be able to call you a friend, Anne.
Absolutely.
And Ken had become a friend. One of the most precious pictures I have in my collection is when he got freedom of the city. And I was one of the two, I'd only been a councillor 3 years, I was fairly inexperienced then. And I got to make a speech, and he wrote the kindest letter to me afterwards and told me about Geordie comics that he'd known, and performing at the Sunderland Empire and places like this, you know. And Whitley Bay's a cold venue as well as a tough venue. Yeah, but you know, I mean, Ken was very dear. The Lady Mayoress fell in love with Ken because she hadn't really known much about him, and I told her how important he was to Liverpool, and when she was just enchanted.
He was easy to get to know.
He was, wasn't he?
Yes.
He was. Yeah. I've never held hands with a councillor, he once before, he said to me, as I took his hand at St. John's Market. And, the joke he told him on occasion still has my wife tickled. It was just a little cheeky comment as I took his hand and walked with him to the stage, and he says, "Ooh," he says, "I've never held hands with a councillor before," and so it's just great little memories, you know, really good memories of Ken, yeah, fantastic.
Okay, so videos and TV, do you want to do?